Well, hi, my lovely. For the Halloween party, I am going to paint you a lovely face. Is there anything in particular that you would like to be for Halloween? Do you want to be something spooky, or do you want to be something majestic, or... Not sure? Well, can I make some suggestions? How about a butterfly? The reason why I say that is I have these beautiful new face paints, and they are absolutely gorgeous. And you could use them to turn yourself into a pumpkin with something nice and orange like this. So you could be nice and festive. Possibilities. Also, something much more elaborate like this beautiful plum color, and this is called Paris, mixed with a couple of other very beautiful colors, such as rose. And these have such beautiful pigmentation. You could paint your entire face with this if you chose. You want to be a beautiful butterfly? Okay. So what color of a butterfly would you like to be? Okay. We'll go with a nice purple and silver. How about that? Mind if I touch your face? Do you have anything currently on your face? Any makeup? Okay. Well, you look beautiful. So why don't we start with the eyes? The eyes are always, in my opinion, the main focus. I'll do like some nice outward brand new clean brush, and I'm just going to establish some of the outside lines, okay? And flare it out. Away from the eyes, a nice wispy. Can you close your eye for a second? This into the crease. Flare out. Have you decided on what you're going to be? You actually go trick-or-treating, or do you want to do something similar to this? Of course I could do your makeup. What I really, really like about this particular makeup, even though I'm painting it on your face, is that it goes on as a cream and then it dries into a nice powder. So it goes on. And I'm going to just take this line and go all the way down your cheek like a majestic butterfly. gonna try my best to make them symmetrical. This really makes your eyes pop. And what we'll do towards the end is we'll add just on the inside corner there a nice light, like a silver metallic. And that way it will really just pop out. Close your eye for me. Thank you. Just gonna paint the crease here. Have a swirl up to your eyebrow. And then feather it out. Just gonna fill in some of that color. I'm gonna use another color to blend it and make it into a transition. How about that? Okay. Alright. So for that one, we used the shade Movie. And now I'm gonna go back with Paris. However you pronounce it. And it has a little bit more of like a pinky tone to it, so it's a little warmer. So I'm going to just trace the inside lines of that, and that way we can really get that subtle and glamorous transition. Okay. So just tracing the insides again. And feathering it together. Halloween, because you can do really flamboyant makeup, and if anybody asks in your professional setting, you can just say that you're being festive. I work in IT. Everyone there is always so serious. But for various holidays, I kind of use it as an excuse. Is it an excuse to be sparkly? I just a little bit more on the inner portion of the eyes here, because this is a really gorgeous color. Thinking. That's a hard one. I think now that we got you filled in, I'm gonna highlight with just a little bit of Widow. And this is a very light and bright. And this will make it pop right out. But I'm gonna use a different brush because I don't want to smear it. Okay, so I'm gonna use a little bit more of like a blending brush because I want to just lighten it up without making it too much of a definite line, okay? Oh boy, that makes it really nice and warm. I'm gonna put some of this on your cheeks too afterwards, just to kind of make everything very very blended and similar theme. we'll add a little bit of like a highlighter that's also pink. Do two different colors here. I'm going to take a silver, which is going to be a very light, and I'm also going to take a very dark, almost a black, and I'm going to do like nice little pattern designs. How does that sound? I can also, I'll do the silver, and then I'll outline them with liquid eyeliner so you have that really distinct line, but then you have the softness of the white metallic. Where's my brush? But check out that beauty. That's what I thought when I first saw it. Make it on the underside. Go ahead and look up for me, because I know this is a ticklish spot. Good job. I can never hold still when someone else does my eye makeup like that. And then on the inner, close your eyes. Thank you. Flare that out. I'm gonna do one really long wisp. The under portion there, so look up. Close your eye. Okay, you can open them. They're not quite symmetrical. One side ended up a little bit thicker than the other, but they're even now. Okay, then one long wisp. Really nice. We'll use a little bit more of that rose color. Because butterflies are beautiful and colorful. And why not? And that's what I have on my hand here. I always found that people with hazel, brown, or green eyes, red, always makes it pop a little bit. So I'm going to use that same color. And I'm going to... How am I going to blend this in? I think I'm going to do it the edges on the inside. Okay. Alright, I'm going to need you to look away though, because I know that this can sometimes really tickle. Oh, that is such a nice pigmented color. And on the corner of the eye right there. want to do more of this color because it just looks so nice on you. I'm going to go inward, like right here, and just create this nice little, like a hoop. Every color possible. Ooh, I know a good way that we can use this. We can paint your eyebrows. I mean, you don't need to have human eyebrows when you're a butterfly. Something out of the Hunger Games. Only way, way cooler. Way, way cooler. Oh, get it, gorgeous. Alright. Let us get that last little eyeliner. And this will make it super, super sharp. And give everything a lot of depth, okay? So you're gonna have to hold still, okay? Looking gorgeous. Look up. And job sitting still. Maybe just like a couple little dots on the inside, like little speckles. Little bit, and you will be all set. I'm going to take a nice pink highlighter, and this is probably like one of my favorite anythings. This is a nice blush, but it has a highlighting effect, so it gives that nice like iridescent shine to it. Since this is going to be a very warm themed look, and as much pink and warm tones as possible. Let's add a little bit more of like a subtle. I have these Luma Pearls.